Okay, so first off, you're in coordination na po with both the Department of Interior and Local Government and the Department of Environmental and Natural Resources, right? Have you also been in contact with ACLAN officials directly? Have they answered your allegations for themselves?
Yeah, since April 5, first week of April, we're closely in touch with the Municipality of Malay through its Tourism Office, checking on its preparation and readiness for the Holy Week.
Mm-hmm. And yung nangyari pong incidents no na breach po tayo ng caps sa Boracay. So how did they explain these to you?
We've been monitoring daily the visitor arrival and the 19,215 daily cap exceeded to 21 and 22,000 on April 14 and 15. So when this number of tourists reached our office, we were provided with data. We immediately called on Malay through its tourism office on the actions that they need to take, mm-hmm. especially that we still have weekends to consider. So they're also doing their best, the LGU putting in measures also while there are still more than 19,000 tourists on the island. So they deployed people to monitor, even putting in their first aid stations, as well as conducting immediately after the April 14, the following day, they conducted their cleaning up in beach areas and walkways.
Mm-hmm. Kanina po, we had on the line ACLAN Acting Mayor Froilan Bautista. Sabi po niya, they would better monitor their hotels, yung mga guests daw po. Is this the right way to go?
It's actually more on checking on the allowed number of tourists through QR codes to enter the island.
Mm-hmm. So more on the entrance po mismo sa island. Okay. And Tourism Secretary Bernard Puyat is urging actions against ACLAN local officials po, di ba? Do you have any updates on this?
So far, no updates pa.
Okay, what exactly are the protocols in place at Boracay and for other tourist destinations in the Philippines for both domestic and foreign tourists?
For alert level one, actually, Ms. Nikki, you still need to present your ID and your vaccination card. But in the case of Boracay, you still have to apply for your QR code to make sure that you are booked in a DOT-accredited accommodation establishments. And we would know also your desired number of stay mm-hmm. in Boracay, as well as, of course, following the health and safety protocols, you need to sign up through their online health declaration certificate.
Mm-hmm. And has an incident similar to this happened in other areas of the Philippines, other tourist destinations over the Holy Week?
In the case of Western Visayas, it's actually just in Boracay mm-hmm. because some of our areas, especially the provinces of Capiz and Iloilo, were badly hit also by Agaton. So efforts were focused on the relief operations, not more on the tourism aspect.
And the Malay Chief Tourism Operations Officer, si Felix Gregorio de los Santos, has since said that they are hoping to have the same tourist arrivals from April 16 up to May 1 when they celebrate Love Boracay or Le Boracay. So what would be the implications of this?
I think with the discussions now with Secretary Puyat and then DILG and DNR, more conscious on the volume of tourists coming in because we really wanted to promote quality experience for our guests. So it's more on the relaxation, serenity of the place. And Boracay now is really ideal for family trips. So it would be best to really sustain that level the allowed capacity in a day. So this is the accumulated number of tourists, those that are coming in for today, and then the remaining tourists that are still on the island. So it's the computation of the total number of tourists in a certain destination, specifically Boracay Island.
And the director, since right now, sabi mo over capacity pa rin ang number of tourists there, are you still, is Boracay supposed to still accept tourists, and are they doing anything about reducing the number of tourists there right now?
Actually, the overcapacity was just on April 14 and 15, and after that, they were able to control the tourist coming in. So we were not also expecting more people to go by land. We calculated also the air seat capacity in a day. It's just over 5,000. So more people visited Boracay by car and also by sea. So we calculated that if we combined all of this, more people are actually doing other mode of transportation. Because in the previous months, now we are looking at 80 to 90% of people are traveling by air. So we did not expect, even the LGU, that more will be using their the land travel to go to the island.
Why do you think this was the case for this year, sa Holy Week?
For this year, we are expecting especially long weekends and holidays. People would really like to see our attractions, to experience our current offerings, especially the new and updated and enhanced tour packages.
Mm-hmm. And lastly, back in October 2021 po, no, si DNR Secretary Royce Matu eyed the possibility of expanding pa Boracay's carrying capacity, noting that the island's rehabilitation may have boosted its capacity to accommodate more tourists. So would this be a good move to push through with this now?
Ms. Nikki, there is an ongoing study, and according to the BIARMG, this is the management group of BIATF. They're expecting to have that study by June 15. Mm-hmm. So it's revisiting also the 2018 carrying capacity survey.
All right. We'll stay tuned for that. Oh, no. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, Director. You stay safe, po.
Thank you.